One of the other aspects of my work is working with children and theatre and education company at the National School of Drama in Delhi, where we started alternate education and learning methodologies for children. And having said that, you see, when we talk about leadership, we always look at the top-down approach. We never look at the bottom-up approach, you know, in most countries of South Asia, not just India and elsewhere. Because the whole concept of academia, going through exams, being competitive, is so important, you know, in our societies, that the whole collaboration between a parent, a school, a scholastic situation for a child, and learning itself, you know, becomes absolutely fragmented. So when we talk about humanizing leadership, which is one of the aspects we are supposed to be talking about today in this session, we can only humanize it when we actually humanize society and we humanize people around us. As adults, you know, our minds are so cluttered with so much stuff, so much angst, so much frustration and failures of our own that we forget, we dump those to our children, to our young people. And it almost looks like walking shadows of failures, you know, that we, pass on representatively to, you know, children and young people around us. So as far as my work is concerned, I do absolutely radical work. I do unboxing, using theater and film as a medium for empowerment and education. And when I say unboxing, the very screen that we are seeing right now is a box. Mm-hmm. The classroom is a box. The table is a box. The whole concept of sitting in a classroom is also a box. So unsquaring and unboxing learning methodologies and creating initiatives which may be round or which are probably semi-circle, very physically speaking, in context, in content, is what we should be doing. Looking at the arts, looking at the whole idiom of using theater and empowerment and cinema as a emancipatory medium has worked tremendously well in a country like India. Let me say to you that I was very, successfully and fortunately a part of a program which Barry John started with the National School of Drama three decades ago. When I was a child, and we started using the role of role play as in creating a role where everything which is bothering you, whether it is a challenge, whether it's a problem, does not find solution theoretically or as a written down piece of paper, but actually role play in theater is such a cathartic method of letting it out and creating wider collaborations. So as far as the idiom of using arts, theater, and cinema collaboratively is concerned, I think there has been path-breaking work in various countries of the world, including India. The only problem is there are deeper collaborations required, with the countries around, very much in the continent, whereas young people can talk to each other. Let me also say to you, India is a very young country. More than 72% of the population of India right now is under 35, and almost more than 50% are women. I would like to bring the focus to women. Let me say this to you, that also in terms of the governance structures and the leadership structures of India, India has done tremendously well at the bottom. That's why I said the top-down approach is highly, deeply flawed and malfunctioned. When you look at the panchayat levels, which is the local self-governing body, sector units of the country, whether you look at, that community development sectors, women have done tremendously well. And a word called quota, which is kosher in the West, has worked tremendously well in terms of a socially leveraging position for women in India. We reserved local self-governing seats, for women in India almost more than two decades ago. And today you have leaders, community leaders, panchayat heads who are women who have gotten out of that whole adage of only knowing 5 or 15 men around them. They are people who take governing who become governance examples because policy has become a part of their lives. There are various paradigms of looking at leadership opportunities for women. I did start a program more than two decades ago where I was also very young then. And when I used to go into the villages and I used to see election campaigns, I used to realize that communicative skills is the biggest challenge apart from finding funds, for elections is concerned. And nobody ever thinks, no political party, even leadership institutes, which otherwise, you know, work on women and, you know, all kinds of things, you know, all across the world, never think of, you know, when a woman is actually starting out in the electoral arena and is facing a first election, how difficult that is for her, because there is no precedent to it. There is nobody who's given her that you know, opportunity of knowing what it means to address an election rally of 500, 5,000, or sometimes 50,000 people. So, as we say, primary education for children is important. Similarly, at a primary level, educative tools, capacity building for women who are fighting their first elections, who want to run for office, is concerned. And that way, I think, despite the fact there are still very few women in the US Senate, at least the United States has invested itself by making democracy institutes and governance and leadership institutes, which invest you know, in creating opportunities for women who want to run for office. India is trying very hard to get there, but the fact that the 11.5% in the parliament still is not representative of the holistic whole of the women who can be future leaders. But the final thing that I was trying to say to you is, reservation or quota is a word that the West hates. Mm-hmm. But let me say, from my own experience, having worked with women and their political participation, you know, at the grassroots level, it's a socially leveraging situation, and it's absolutely required. It's apt because it creates that paradigm which is so much required for women to enter the mainstream. And that is why the grassroots level experience I shared with you is a tremendous, tremendous affair. And I have so much more to say, but really I have paucity of time. But thank you so much for having me on, and let's keep the fire burning. That's all that I can say.
Absolutely. Thank you.